Today on Mike Attempts, balancing battery packs. Towards the end of charging, all four bars are lit up on this Milwaukee M18 battery pack. However, once finished, only three bars light up. And if I put it back on the charger, it shows fully charged. This is usually a sign of cell imbalance. I have the same problem with a smaller 2 amp hour battery pack. Let's crack them open. To get inside a Milwaukee pack, we're going to need a Torx TS10 security bit. If your battery pack is from another brand, this inexpensive kit has all the security bits you should ever need. Or you could get a screwdriver like this, with common bits in the handle. The nice thing about the screwdriver is that the same bit is much more narrow, so you can get into tighter spaces. This bit can't reach the screws on this pack, but the thinner one works perfectly. The regular size bit works fine on the smaller packs. Four screws, and we're in. There are 10 cells in this 8 amp hour battery pack. The negative end of the cell is flat, while the positive end has a shallow ring around the center. To find the unbalanced cells, we'll need a basic multimeter. I set it to 9 volt DC because these cells are 4.2 volts when fully charged. This larger pack seems to have a thin coating on all of the metal parts. It's probably to prevent corrosion, but it's making it difficult to get a good reading. I found that twisting the leads in the indentation of a spot weld made a better connection. Because of how they're connected, I assumed each reading was for multiple cells, but that's only partially correct. More on that later. At 3.93 volts, it's the front bank that's low. We'll also need a battery charger to, you know, charge the batteries. I chose this charger for four specific reasons. It's capable of discharging if we'd prefer to balance the cells that way. It has a touchscreen that shows all the important information. It comes with a power cord that plugs into an outlet instead of USB. And, most importantly, at only $12, it was cheap. We'll need something non-conductive to place in the battery slot. This is just a scrap piece of plastic I cut to size. A wood dowel would work great too. I stripped the insulation off the ends of these two wires and crimped on spade connectors. I'll use the white wire for positive and black for negative. I crimped a ring connector on one end of the negative wire because the negative terminal on the charger has a raised center. With the plastic rod inserted, the wires are held in place. Lithium-ion batteries can violently catch fire if a cell is smashed, punctured, short-circuited, overcharged, or overheated, so be careful. The wires need to be connected to opposite sides of the same cell. I slid one prong of the spade terminal behind the tab on the positive side, and did the same for the negative. After plugging in the power cord, charging starts automatically after a few seconds. The default charging rate is 500 milliamps. The screen looks a little blurry on camera, but it's clear in person. Once charging, the settings cannot be changed. This is going to take forever at 500 milliamps, so I reset the charger and selected 1,000 milliamps. Finally, we got a green light. It took almost 4 hours to charge. I'm learning as I go and was surprised it took so long, but I'll soon figure out exactly what's happening. Now all four bars light up. However, when checking the cells individually, I found two that were still not charged. Since the banks can be measured using the tabs on top, I assumed the whole bank would charge together, but that's not the case. I connected the wires to the top cell and set the charger to 2000 milliamps. I figured these larger packs were made to be charged faster and didn't notice any heat from the higher milliamps. When finished, I realized why the larger pack took so long to charge. By connecting the wires to the top cell, it also charges the cell directly under it. Now we should be good to go. Something caused the battery to become unbalanced, so I don't know if or when it'll happen again. Since rebalancing, I've drained this pack all the way down twice. And once recharged, it's still lighting up all four bars. Now for the smaller 2 amp hour pack. I had to cut the decal in order to split the case. It's the front bank that's low on this pack too. I decided to charge these cells at 1000 milliamps. Since they aren't stacked, only one cell would charge at a time. That one took a little over 2 hours. I'm sure 2000 milliamps would be fine, but I'm not in a hurry. We're getting 4 bars now. But when checked individually, this one needs to be charged as well. So, if it's a double row of cells like the larger pack, the cells charge in pairs. If it's a single row like the smaller pack, the cells charge individually. Maybe the larger 3-row packs, like a 12 amp hour, might charge 3 cells at a time, but I haven't tried one of those yet. That took less than an hour. Fixed. Those went so well, I'm gonna give these older packs a try. Fully charged, they only have 2 bars. And after sitting for about 30 minutes, the one on the right dropped to 1 bar. These are the original batteries that came with the first Milwaukee tool I ever purchased back in 2009. Since they're almost 17 years old, I assumed some of the cells were bad. Let's find out. Four of the 5 cells are low. Same for the second pack. I charged 4 cells on each pack. Instead, I could have used discharge mode to reduce the charge of a single cell. Reassembling these older packs is a bit more challenging because of the loose spring-loaded locks. If any of these packs end up failing, I'll do another video replacing the bad cells. Feel free to rate this video, add your comments and questions below, and subscribe for more.